Hello everyone, this is Marwan from Exalate. Today I'll be showing you a quick tutorial on how to set up an integration between Jira Cloud and ServiceNow using the Exalate basic connection method. For this, we have a ServiceNow instance where we have Exalate already deployed for it. And we have a Jira Cloud instance where we also have Exalate already deployed. As you can see inside of the Jira Cloud apps section, you can see the Exalate menu with all of the different options that Exalate provides. And for ServiceNow, we also have the Exalate node where we can see all of the same options as we have in Jira Cloud. In order to perform the installation, you can just very quickly visit our docs pages, docs.exalate.com. Scroll down a bit, and then you can see this section right here, where you can select the platforms that you would like to connect. And then it shows you all of the different ways that this connection can be established. Moving on from there, let's get our systems connected. So it doesn't really matter where we start the connection from, as Exalate is a decentralized and a full bidirectional synchronization solution. However, for the sake of this tutorial, I'll be starting the connection from Jira. So on the Exalate side, we're just going to head down to the Connections tab. All right. You can see that I already have a couple of connections. These are currently not active, so I'm not using these. But also, I want to know to mention that you can set up multiple connections from the same Exalate node to different environments. So whether this is ServiceNow or any other supported platform. So we're just going to initiate the connection by pressing this button. It will ask us to provide the remote URL or the remote node URL, so where we're trying to connect to. So I'm just going to take this URL from the ServiceNow side. Paste it in here, where Exalate will validate that it can actually connect to this node and show us the different connection methods. Just like I mentioned in the beginning of this video, we're going to cover the basic sync method, which covers synchronizing your summary, description, comments, and attachments. This mode does not allow you to configure any kind of custom field synchronization or status mapping or anything like that. It's also limited to 1,000 synchronization events per month, which is still plenty for simple use cases. So with the basic mode connected, we're going to click Next. It asks us to provide a project, considering that Jira uses a project-based configuration. If we would send any incident from ServiceNow to Jira, this is basically the project where all of the new issues will be created in Jira itself. We're going to click Next. Now, to set up a basic connection, it does require you to be an admin on the other side. If you don't, you can just say that I don't have admin access. It will provide you a invitation code that you can just copy and paste on the connection side on ServiceNow. So for now, I do have admin access. I'm already logged in, so I'm just going to select that. There's another window that opens just to verify the admin access on ServiceNow. And considering I'm already logged in, this should not be a problem. So as you can see, the connection is now established. So this is currently now showing me actually the screen of ServiceNow. So I'm just going to close out of this because I already have it open on the other side. And click out of here. Now it already prompts us to synchronize a ticket, if that's what we want to do. For the moment, I'm just going to exit out of this menu and show you how to synchronize it from the user interface itself. You can see here also that we have a connection established. It's just taking the name of my project here on Jira and the name of the node on ServiceNow to create the name of the connection. And if we head over to the ServiceNow instance, and we scroll down a bit, you can see the same connection over here. I'm just going to create a quick issue on the Jira side. So, synchronize to ServiceNow. All right. So, I mean, I created a task. This can be any kind of entity within within Jira. It doesn't really matter. From the UI of the issue itself, we have an Exalate tab over here that we can open that shows us two types of actions. One is Exalate. This allows us to send this ticket and all of the aforementioned fields, so the summary, description, comments, and attachments that are available here, and send them basically to ServiceNow. So for the sake of completion, let's also just add an attachment very quickly. And a comment. And the other action that we can perform is to connect this ticket with a different ticket on ServiceNow side. So it provides us a small menu where we can choose the selection that we're working with, the connection that we're working with, and it will ask us to provide a unique incident number from ServiceNow that we would like to connect to. And there are also some options for you if you want to already send some data while doing the connection of the two tickets. However, for the moment, we're just going to send this task to ServiceNow. So we're going to press Exalate. Again, select the connection that we are currently using and press Exalate. And how Exalate works is basically it will take the information that is available in this task that we have in Jira. It will compile all that information in a data object and send it over to ServiceNow, where Exalate receives it, does the reverse, so it unpacks that information, and based on the Exalate configuration, it will basically create a new incident in ServiceNow. When it's done, just like it is done now, it shows us that the status is synchronized. It also provides us the actual incident that was created. So if I just open this here, and give it a second to load, we see that this is the incident that we created. So this is the comment that we have, the description that we have provided, and the attachment that we have attached on the Jira side. So we can just quickly reply to this. Post it. In order to save it, it will require me to assign someone to this ticket. So we'll do that. Update it. And now that this incident in ServiceNow is updated, it will trigger a another synchronization event that will basically push our comment back to Jira Cloud. Right, so we'll just give it a second, and then we should see our comment arrive over here. All right, so here's a comment from ServiceNow. All right, a different way of synchronizing your tickets or incidents is by going to the Exalate menu itself, and then we have an entity sync status tab where we can look for any specific issue that we would like to send. So currently, you know, it's looking for issues by default. If you have different entities, you can select these. If we look at the one that we have already sent out, so that is 122. We can search, we can see that it is synchronized. We can also unexcelate it to break the connection between the task that we have in Jira Cloud and the incident that we have created on ServiceNow. And if I look for, you know, if there's something new that we created and we look for it, it will of course not be synchronized, but then you will have the same options to synchronize or connect it to an existing incident on the other side. All right, so this covers basically the functionality for the basic mode. And then we'll create another tutorial to show you how the script mode works between these two different platforms. So thank you very much for joining. And if you have any questions, please just visit exalate.com to get in touch with us and possibly book a demo. Thank you for watching.